Hello, happy site owners and webmasters. Man here with the BlogAid Today tips and breaking news for October 25th, 2018. So we got some really happy news coming out. Look at this. WordPress 5.0, the first beta, was released yesterday. And you know, this came right to the top of my testing list. And what I'm going to be testing are 14 ways to turn Gutenberg off. I'm not kidding you. There really are 14 ways to turn it off, and I'm going to be testing most of them. I probably won't test all of them because I know some of them are kind of whack, but I'm going to be testing those because we're going to want to turn that thing off just prior to the release of 5.0, because I'm advising folks, let's not use Gutenberg yet. It's not mature enough. It's going to make things whack and whatever. Now, I do have a test site set up that has the Gutenberg plugin on it, and I'm going to be pulling that plugin and going to this instead because it's in the core, and you can't really test those ways to disable it on a plugin. It needs to be in the core to see what's going on. So this is what I've been waiting for. It's like, I'll tell you what to use when I get to test. Well, this is why I've been waiting, you know, for this, to actually test these things and whatever. So came right to the top of my list for doing that. So be sure that you're following me on Blog. Best place here is on Facebook. Follow, like, and turn on notifications so you know when I go live with this kind of thing, you know, for that. And so I let all of my peeps, the BlogAid News peeps and my site audit clients for sure, I let them know right away. Plus my webmasters, you know, we're all keeping up with this. So they get first dibs on all of the news. And then I post it out when I've got hard evidence of everything, you know, if I'm checking into stuff and whatever. So the second thing, and woohoo, I am so tickled about this. The new Google Search Console course went live in the DIY SEO course today. So woo! So if you're already, now this is part of the DIY SEO course. It's not something extra that you have to buy. It's inside that course. It's got several little courses inside that one big course, and this is one of them. And I'm so thrilled for that going live today. So that's great. And thank you so much to the folks who helped me beta test. We got extra screenshots. So you can see examples of the link stuff that you're going to run into. Because, honey, you're going to run into Goofy. And you are going to have questions about it. So everybody that's already in the course, you can access it right now. I sent out an email earlier today for that. And everybody in our Facebook group, you know, we have a support group for it. It's like, yay, I can't wait to jump in. Now, here's the thing. Go ahead and poke all you want to. But come November, just like, you know, another week or so, I'm going to start having live flash challenges to help you get through the most important reports in there and what you're seeing, and help you get through some of this goofy that you're going to see in there. Because I guarantee you're going to see goofy if you've got a lot of traffic to your site and a bunch of links and whatever. Now, if you've got a site that ain't doing much, maybe not. But, you know, most of my clients are making money, you know, and so they got stuff going on. And there's going to be goofy. There's going to be things in there that are a waste of time. I'm going to glide you right through all of that, and where you can ask questions about it and send examples of what you're seeing and whatever, and we'll drill down into it and see what's going on with that. So I'm just really thrilled to get this course out to you. Plus, we're going to be doing our live workshops again starting in January. And so the technical SEO, when you're going to have to know Google Search Console to be able to make sense of the technical SEO workshop. And don't get too about the word technical. It just means technically, can Google crawl your site and what is it finding? And that's what Google Search Console is all about, is showing you what Google can crawl, or if it's having problems crawling, and then what it's finding, and how you're showing up in search. And boy, that's so crazy important to know how well you're doing in search to make sure that your SEO efforts are working well. That's what Google Search Console is all about. It's helping you do better. Well, you got to figure out how to use it to do better, right? Yeah, that's a big part of it. So I'm just thrilled about that. I'm going to jump over here and see if anybody is with us. I'm going to go to the live thing and see if anybody's, oh, hi, Larry. Good to see you here. And I haven't been on very long here, so you didn't miss much. But yeah, I know everybody's looking forward to the Google Search Console course. Even me, I was looking forward to diving really super deep into this. And when I did, I was, what? It's really confusing. It's very different. The interface is very different from the original. This course is on the new interface. Extremely different getting around. Don't know what to make of the reports and where the language is different, the whole thing. So the very first part of the course takes you right through. This is how you get around. This is what things are. This is what they do. This is why you want to look at it. And just how to navigate some of the tricks. Because if you hit your back button or hit certain things on the reports, it changes the information you get. I wish I had known something like that up front. It took a while. But once I get past all that, it's like, okay, this is kind of cool. And it's got some information in there that the original does not. Now, it's also missing some things that you can't do in the new interface that you have to go back to the old interface for. And if you hit one of those, it'll say, oh no, it'll pop you over to the old interface. And what? You know. So that's going to be the next segment of this course, is me going through all the different little features and little things that you have to do and finding out what you can't do on the new one and adding those tutorials into this same course for it. So, you know, it's going to come out in segments. And then the last segment of it is going to be how to make use of all this. Because like the performance report, I'll tell you what it is, but how do you make really good use of that for the kind of content that you're developing and the stuff that's ranking well? How do you write more of that? How do you bring others up? If you're going to be deleting a bunch of content, what do you do for that? How is that going to show up? If you change your Yoast SEO settings, how is that going to show up? So there's little segments to this course, but the main thing is we got to get used to even using it, knowing what it's telling us, and going there and looking. Just don't go, blah, 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 you know, googly-eyed going, I don't know what I'm looking at, so I'm going to jump out. No, I'm going to take you through that so you will know what you're looking at and get you into the habit of logging into it regularly and looking at some of these things. I know a few of my clients last year when we did the technical SEO workshop, I do that one first because it could take you 4 or 5 months to finish fixing all of the issues. Now, I know people who are going to repeat the workshop in this January, you know, people took it last year, they're going to repeat it because, honey, SEO changes all the time, right? And you can't just take one course and that's it. It's constant with this. They saw results, and we're going to go back over some of that. Some people got themselves into a little bit of trouble with the way that they did things. We learned from all of that, and so I'm going to go way deeper into deleting, republishing, reposting, you know, how you repurpose your stuff and content and that kind of thing. So we're going to go a lot deeper. The workshops will change. Now, you can get replays from the workshops we had, and they're still good. But I'm changing them for next year because we have whole other concerns. And especially for the stuff that's showing up in here. I mean, there's a ton of information in here that's going to just waste your time. And you're going to need to know what to kind of skim over and other things to really hone in and pay attention to. And then take the fixes in little small chunks. That's why it takes a few months to do all that. And I'm going to have better tutorials for you and that kind of thing about those fixes. So there's more coming, but I know y'all are all busy right now, so let's take it in itty-bitty small chunks so you can get a grip, get used to using it, see what the issues are, make a plan for what to do about it, and then know how to implement that plan before you just go make a bunch of changes. Know what the ramifications are. So there's more to it, and we're just going to take the whole thing in little chunks. Hi, Isabella. She's saying, I haven't tried the new console yet. I'm on the old one, but I'll venture into it now. Right. And I have to tell you, all these goofy emails we've been getting, Google Search Console found an issue. Go see what it is. You had to go into the new Search Console to even find that information. Half the time it's bogus crap, you know? And Search Console's not been without its bugs, too. They had a couple bugs, and we tried our best to run down some of the links that it was showing us. We couldn't make any sense. It's like, where is this stuff coming from? And it ended up being a Google bug, you know? So it's like, oh, great. Thanks for wasting my time. There are several things like that that will just absolutely chew you up on time for no gain whatsoever. We're seeing tons more information in the new one than we were in the old one. Useless information, too. Well, I don't know that it's absolutely useless, but it's nothing that you need to take action on. Like, you've got 2,500 pages excluded. Uh-huh. I meant to set it that way. You know, it's things like that that are excluded in Yoast. Uh-huh. Like your date archives, your author archives. If you're the only blogger, they're all going to be the same thing. You don't index anything but the canonical. So you're excluding all of these exact copies. Meant to. And Google's, I'm freaking out because you've got all this stuff excluded. And it's like, and I meant to do it that way. It's a, what a waste of time. So we're seeing a ton of information that we need to make sense of so we can vet it and say, is this something I need to check into or is this just a waste of time? For things, yeah, I told you. And then some goofiness in there about some of the things that it's like, oh my God, why show me all this hundreds and thousands of links that are correct? We didn't have that in the old one. That's why we didn't have any of this goofiness. So you're definitely going to want this course. And especially if you're getting these emails, you can't just put them on ignore. And when we first started getting them, my peeps were panicking. And we got it. I said, don't panic. Don't just dump it on me either and say, hey, I got this email and I don't know what it is. Here. Read it. And with the help of this course and the examples that are in there, you're going to be able to go, oh, okay, I know what that is. See? Knowledge is a powerful thing. So I'm really looking forward to this. I'm also really looking forward to disabling Gutenberg for real and see what's going on. Now, let me go back up to this for a minute because I got all happy about the new course. Let me go back up here to Gutenberg. They're thinking about releasing this sometime in November because the beta's out. I think that's what they're going to do. It was either that or January. And everybody was kind of almost pushing for January because this is going to come across our holidays. And there are a lot of people very upset about that because, you know, so many users in the U.S., this is going to be right across the holidays. And they're pretty unhappy about that. Now, I think it hits before the holiday. We'll see. I'll believe it when I see it come out. But anyway, so we'll see for sure. It really depends on what they find in these betas and how long it takes for a release candidate. So they can put all the dates they want to in the world out there. I'll believe it when I see it. But I will be prepared. I will have you prepared way before the thing hits, right? And so we'll know exactly what we're going to do with this thing prior to it coming out. So it won't goof us up at all. And all those millions of site owners who are unaware of what's happening are going to scream bloody murder when this thing hits. You know, what is this all over? You're ahead of the curve, and that's where I intend to keep us all, including me. So, all right, guys, I just wanted to jump on right quick and let you know the news, and woohoo, I am so happy. I got some other news for you, but it's going to come out in Tips Tuesday next week. That's 100% must read for all site owners so you can stay up and then catching these BlogAid Today tips, and I'll see you online.